Hello, this is the first video of the first sequence and series section on summing series for the OCR Pure Core Further Mathematics syllabus. We start by revising the sigma notation. The use of the Greek capital letter sigma indicates that we're going to carry out an operation to sum. And here we can see that we are going to sum terms 2r from r equals 1 to 5. So we will have 2 times r, which initially is 1, and then add 2 times 2, where r is 2, and so on, up until the point when r reaches that upper limit of 5. That will give us 2 plus 4 plus 6 plus 8 plus 10, which when we add them together or sum them gives us 30. In this example here, you can see that in this case the r goes from 4 to 7. So we could write that out as 3 times 4 plus 3 times 5 plus 3 times 6 plus 3 times 7. Alternatively, we could have rewritten this as being equal to taking the 3 out, the sum between r is 4 and 7 of r. So we can take the scalar multiple out. Sometimes this saves us a little bit of time in terms of the calculation. But either way, we would end up with 3 times 22, or 66. You may be wondering what happens in a situation where we don't have an r that we are summing. We could rewrite this as 3 lots of r equals 1 to n, just summing the unit 1. Let's think about what actually happens here. So every time from r equals 1 to n, we are just summing the term 1. So this component will actually be n lots of 1. So we can see that that would then equal 3n. This leads us to the general conclusion that if we are summing the unit between 1 and n, the answer will just be n. In this example here, we need to express the sum of 1 times 3 plus 2 times 4 plus 3 times 5 right up to 50 times 52 using sigma notation. We should be looking for the pattern. We may note that for every one of those first numbers in the bracket, the second number, let's call that first number r, the second number is always 2 more. So let's call that r plus 2. Using the sigma notation, we can see that we were starting at r equals 1, and then r goes up to the value of 50. And the expression that we're actually summing is r times r plus 2. We could go on then to calculate that expression, but we would have to use some standard formula to help us do this, or it might be rather a tedious task. In the next video, 1.2, we will look at the standard formula for the sum to n terms of r.